joining us. First move, adoption of the minutes of the previous meeting.
Move that, Mr. Mayor.
All in favor?
Aye.
Carried. Thank you. Councillor Brody.
Thank you very much, Your Worship. This morning I'd like to take a couple moments to recognize everybody that was involved in the fantastic hosting of the 103rd Grey Cup here in Winnipeg. First of all, to the winners, the Edmonton Eskimos. I know it looked like you were having some fun with Mayor Iveson of Edmonton over the weekend, and it was great to see so many Canadians with football jerseys from across the country here this weekend. Our public service was also came to the plate and did a fantastic job, led by Kenny Boyce, who is the City of Winnipeg's head of our City of Winnipeg's operations on the host committee. Various departments were intimately involved in various aspects throughout the whole piece. Winnipeg Transit moved tens of thousands of people very successfully throughout the weekend. The Winnipeg Police Service had extra crews directing people and making everyone safe and feel safe. The Winnipeg Fire Paramedic Service, the Public Works Department, the Winnipeg Parking Authority, Planning, Property, and Development, 311 and Corporate Communications, Legal Services, all these various city departments had an active role in aspects of it. The Grey Cup Festival itself, though, involved many other groups throughout the City of Winnipeg. A lot of local organizations were involved in it. There were not many people that were flown in from Toronto or anything else. This was a homegrown festival, and a lot of local groups were very intimately involved. My buddy Jonathan Strauss in Strauss Event Management did a fantastic job hosting the very first event in the expanded RBC Convention Center Winnipeg. The gala was, I believe, perhaps the largest gala ever hosted in our city, and for sure the largest Grey Cup gala ever held, with something in the neighborhood of 2,600 attendees. FACE Face Productions, Stephanie Millier and Jen Matheson, very involved. Ugly Duckling Productions, Rose Passante and Karen Mott. Planners Plus, Carmen Newfield. Pop Entertainment, Angie Lamarand and David Sherman. Winnipeg Parade Committee, Executive Director Ron Mark. Morrow Productions, Melissa Morrow. Events by Emma Singh. You couldn't escape in Winnipeg. You hopped off a plane somewhere. The Winnipeg Airport was just jam-packed with Grey Cup visuals. Throughout our city, banners, everything everywhere. Again, this was, I think, a really good example of how things can go very right. And I think a big congratulations to everyone involved and to all Winnipeggers for your participation.
Thank you very much, and I think all of us echo your comments and sentiment and words of appreciation. Okay, we'll move to delegates. Councillor Schreier.
The delegation we have registered is Councillor Schreier and Crystal Van de Bouche, here to speak on the Winnipeg Committee for Safety, 2014 report.
Welcome. Thanks for joining us this morning.
I'm not really here to speak, Your Worship. Basically, just to make the statement, I'm here as a member of the Winnipeg Committee for Safety to state that, the reason I'm here is that Ms. Van den Bosch is technically not our coordinator. And it's the convention for the coordinator to make the presentation. In this case, we're not in a position to choose our coordinator. That's done by a greater process, including, I believe, by the EPC, which will be done earlier in the new year. On that basis, Ms. Van den Bosch is making the presentation as the acting consultant, basically doing the work de facto of the coordinator. And I'm here merely to state, as a member, to sort of symbolically offer that continuity of the committee during this in this year where in which we actually didn't have a coordinator for a few months. It happened to be that our coordinator was in an unfortunate bicycle accident, and it threw us off for a few months, but we're back on our feet, and Ms. Van den Bosch is here to make the presentation. And just to state that we continue to follow process to the best of our abilities with the absence of a coordinator, and this can be attested to by the committee members and by Jennifer Ridge, who has been the clerk to the committee for at least a decade, I believe. And from here on in, I'll just leave this to Ms. Van den Bosch to make the presentation on our behalf.
Thanks.
Well, good morning.
Morning.
So as been stated, my name is Crystal Vandenbush, and I'm the consultant for the coordinators. So, for the committees. So I came on board at the end of September, early October, to sort of do the unfinished business that was left over and, of course, to carry the committee forward. So part of what the unfinished business was the annual report that sits before you. So as Councillor Schreier has mentioned, the committee did suffer a loss, but we are strong looking forward. So I know that there's a really packed agenda for this morning. I'm just going to quickly highlight some of the things in the report. So let's begin. Of course, we talk about the mandate of the Winnipeg Committee for Safety, which is to support, assist, stimulate, and mobilize the community on safety concerns and crime prevention. When we can, we aim to work proactively with citizens to help make their communities safer. Of course, we have a message from the chairman in this report, Councillor Jason Schreier, who talks about some of the things that were focused on in 2014. So, for example, addressing the gang problem in Winnipeg and working with a variety of groups to identify and neutralize hotspots for neighborhood crime and things like that. 2014 actually just happened to mark the 15th anniversary of this committee, so I wanted to highlight just a couple of the things that that they have accomplished. They've worked closely with LiveSafe, which is a crime prevention initiative, and they continue to work in an advisory role in that capacity. They've also led the City of Winnipeg in their pursuit for a safe communities designation. That was achieved in 2008. And, of course, throughout the years, continue to work with different programming, so youth engagement programming, anti-gang programs, and things like that. So moving forward to 2014, one of the focuses that we had was working with GAIN, which is the Gang Action Interagency Network. They are a network of agencies, governments, and law enforcement officials that work with grassroots solutions to the gang problem. They released last year their community assessment of a gang exit strategy. And one of the needs that they found and that we support continuously is a database for at-risk youth, service providers, families, that just has the relevant resources, programs that are available to them. Another focus of 2014 was, of course, acting proactively and designing out crime. So the coordinator, as well as the committee, has conducted SEPTED audits. So SEPTED, crime prevention through environmental design, and working closely with the Winnipeg Police Service and property planning and development to ensure that those principles are met. And there's a bit more information here about SEPTED and how it works, the seven sort of tenets of SEPTED, and how they can reduce crime and fear and, of course, ensure that citizens feel safe and secure in their communities. And that's pretty much the gist of the annual report. And going forward, I just want to mention, of course, that the committee continues to work with various community agencies. So we're working with the Broadway Neighborhood Center, and the Spence Neighborhood Association is doing a safety charter as we speak. And also we're supporting the West End 24/7 project to support a safe space in that area. We are happy to have a representative from the province on the committee now. She's from the Crime Prevention Unit, so we haven't had somebody from the province in about 7 years, so this is really exciting. I've also connected with Councillor Gilroy, and we're doing work with the UN Safe Cities Initiatives, and I'm hoping to do some work with some grassroots organizations regarding missing and murdered Indigenous women. So we've got a lot of important work to do going forward. And we're also on Twitter. So if you feel like following us, we're at Winnipeg Safety. I'm following everybody here, so feel free to give a follow.
Great. What was the handle again?
Winnipeg Safety, WPG Safety.
Just giving you another plug for the
Yeah, thank here, you. So. That's great. Yes, feel free to follow back. I'm just throwing that out there.
Well, thank you very much to both of you for coming here today and for the report. And please extend our appreciation to everybody involved. I know Councillor Gilroy is working hard on safe cities, and so I'm pleased to hear that consultation is happening. Councillor Mays?
More just a comment than a question because you're up here, but A, Councillor Schreier is is into this. He's doing a good job on this. I think I've heard more about this committee in the past year than in the previous 3 years, not to denigrate it, but Councillor Schreier's into it, so I appreciate that. And if you can pass on our best wishes to Brody, the coordinator, who I locked horns with a couple of times, but he was into his job. He knew what he was doing. He was passionate about this stuff, so I hope he can recover and come back, keep work on it, because he was passionate about this stuff.
Is the report available via your Twitter feed?
It's not. It can be. It will be available online via our website, which is winnipegsafety.ca. Okay. There'll be a PDF for everyone. So, yeah. And those copies in front of you are yours to treasure and keep.
Great. Great. Thank you very much.
Thank
Have
you.
A great day to both of you.
Thank you.
That's it for delegates. Okay. So we'll move to reports. Report one is Centre Venture mandate review.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I wish to move it.
Okay. Questions, comments? Okay. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Carried. Report two is the Centre Venture Development Corp long-term funding solution.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I'd like to move this and make a few comments, if I may.
Sure, of course.
This the long-term funding solution will be the solution that we're going to have to find out very quickly. We bridged the financing for the year, but we will be setting up a working group immediately to look at the options, not only the ones that are listed here, but other options that may come forward, to find a way that we could continually have sustainable funding for Centre Venture to allow them to continue to be our development agency in a nimble, able way. So again, the kind of mandate review and in the long-term funding solution model, they'll both be kind of combined together in this working group. There's some good recommendations by the public administration about some accountability measures and some transparency measures, and we just have to find a way to meet our objectives, but also allowing Centre Venture to continue the great work they're doing.
That's good. Thank you very much, Councillor Orlico. Councillor Lukes.
I'd just like to thank Councillor Orlico for the leadership that he's provided on this review committee. You know, Councillor Mays and I participated in it, but truly, Councillor Orlico, you led the charge. And it was very appreciated, and for the administration for doing so much work on helping put this together. So I think we've got a really good solution we're working towards, and thanks.
I'll just echo that. I want obviously thank Councillor Orlico, both Councillor Mason and Lukes for your time and efforts involved in this review. Particularly impressed that there were over 40 stakeholders consulted, including of course Centre Venture's board and many others. With these motions, we're recognizing that Centre Venture is a key agency and facilitating development and downtown growth. And we're reaffirming it as a key City of Winnipeg agency tasked with providing leadership in the planning, the development, the coordination, and the implementation of projects and activities in downtown Winnipeg. Additionally, we're recommending that oversight, accountability, and reporting mechanisms be strengthened by including in Centre Venture's next business plan performance indicators and targets, a regular reporting schedule to council, and a business case template to better ensure public accountability over public funds. And so I too want to thank everybody involved, including of course Centre Venture, for their collaboration to get to this point. If there are no further questions or comments, we'll call the question. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Carried. Thanks. Okay. Report three is open and accessible data initiative.
Mr. Mayor,
did you did you want to speak briefly? Morning, Linda. Thanks.
Morning. This report is not here this morning, as you will note in your agenda, so I'm here to request a 60-day extension. Just because of the holiday season coming up, would appreciate having the 60-day extension. We're pretty much complete, but just need a bit more time.
Okay. On that note, Mr. Mayor, I'd be happy to move a 60-day extension to item number 3.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Carried. Thanks very much. Thanks, Linda. Have a great morning. We'll move to Report 4, which is the Winnipeg Committee for Safety.
That report, Mr. Mayor.
Joking. All in favor?
Aye.
Carried. Report 5, zoning agreement amendment for 155 Williamson Crescent.
Mr. Mayor, so moved.
All in favor?
Aye.
Carried. Thank you. Report 6 is grant to the General Council of Winnipeg Community Centers, Glenwood Community Center area, or sorry, arena project.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Pleased to move this. Three levels of government, several years, DCWCC involved, rather complex. Some good work by Karen Beck and Mike McGinn from our staff, and I think we're at the finish line here finally. So I'll move this item number 6.
All in favor?
Aye.
Carried. Thank you. Report 7, Winnipeg Police Pension Fund Letter of Credit.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I will move item number 7.
Okay. All in favor?
Aye.
Carried. Thank you. I'm going to pass the chair to our deputy mayor for this one, so I can...
Mr. Mayor, on number 8, Office of Integrity Ethics Commissioner.
Thanks very much. I'll move this motion. The report before us today sets the stage for the establishment of an Office of Integrity Commissioner, whose mandate would be to investigate, advise, and educate members of council on matters relating to conflict of interest and other laws and policies governing the behavior of council. Implementing an integrity commissioner will provide an open and accessible report process. A process to report perceived conflicts of interest with sitting councillors. As well, it'll support councillors with advice and educational activities aimed at strengthening the overall understanding of existing laws and policies governing council behavior. The Office of Integrity Commissioner will provide transparent, accessible, and open process through with councillors and members of the public may report or receive information on perceived conflicts of interest by a sitting member of council. Several municipalities in Canada have implemented similar commissioners and officers. And you'll recall that earlier this year I brought forward a motion to council with Councillor Jenny Gervasi to prepare a process and implementation plan to create an Office of Ethics Commissioner within the maximum authority provided for under the existing City of Winnipeg Charter. So the city could move forward with a matter that was to help provide openness and transparency and provide accountability within the abilities of the city under the charter. The City of Winnipeg Charter Act currently doesn't specifically provide investigative authority nor identify appropriate penalties for breaching relevant policies, bylaws, or acts. And as such, changes can continue to be recommended to the City of Winnipeg Charter in order to specifically grant the Integrity Commissioner investigative powers and identify appropriate penalties. And we'll continue to work with our provincial partners to ensure the powers to investigate as granted through the charter amendments noted in the report going forward.
Thank you very much, Mr. Mayor, on that motion. Any further speakers on the motion? Seeing none, I'll call the question. All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Carried. Back to you, Mr. Mayor.
Great. Thanks, Councillor. We'll go to Report 9, which is sponsorship agreement with Raiders Hockey, Inc.
It's my pleasure to move item number 9, Mr. Mayor.
Okay. All in favor?
Aye.
Carried. Report 10, request for first charge against 2016 capital budget for P3 contract.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I will move this item number 10 with respect to our P3 payments.
All in favor?
Aye.
Carried. Report 12, subdivision rezoning, 113 St. Anne's Road.
No. 11.
Sorry, 11? Sorry, sorry.
Not intentional.
Single source negotiation and award of contract, bacterial logical monitoring for city's water supply and distribution system.
Happily move number 11.
Okay. All in favor?
Aye.
Carried. Thank you for that catch. Report 12, subdivision and rezoning for 113 St. Anne's.
Yeah, I'm happy to move this. It's in my ward. Mr. Mayor, do we need to suspend the rules? First, I guess we'll move to suspend the rules.
Okay, so all in favor?
Aye.
Carried.
Happy to move this. We sometimes get criticized for not backing infill projects. I want to thank Councillor Lukes, who voted for this Monday night, along with Councillor Lard. It's what people think we should approve. Basically, it's an infill project mix of commercial and residential on St. Anne's Road. It's near two or three different bus routes, depending if you count the express as a separate route. It's what we're trying to do on some of our main streets, our corridors, quality corridors. So I think it's a fine project, and there was no community opposition at the public hearing.
Thank you very much. All in favor?
Aye.
Carried. We'll move to Audit Committee.
Yes, so Mr. Mayor, there's four items here. I'd be happy to move items 1, 2, 3, and 4 as information.
All in favor?
Aye.
Carried. Thank you. Committee report. Standing Policy Committee on Water and Waste, Riverbank Management, and the Environment.
First report. I'll move item number 1.
Discharge.
All in favor?
Aye.
Carried.
Nice.
Thank you. We'll move to Standing Policy Committee on Infrastructure and Public Works.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. This is the report on November 24th, and I'd like to move item number 1, please.
All in favor?
Aye.
Carried. Thank you. We'll move to addendum, Standing Policy Committee on Property and Development, Heritage, and Downtown Development.
I'll move items 1 through 11.
All in favor?
Aye.
Carried.
Move consent and adjournment, Mr. Mayor.
All in favor?
Aye.
We're adjourned. Thanks, everyone. Have a great day.
So you were.